notice that after a period of time, your diet will stop working. And this video, I want to explain why that is the case. Hello, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jody and I help you change your beliefs so you can change your body, your health, and your life. This video, we're talking about weight loss and why it is that it slows down and even stops after a period of time, even if you're sticking to the same diet that you were from the start when it was working. Why does that diet stop working? Now, in order to understand why, you have to first understand how weight loss works. Now, I am assuming in this whole video that weight loss equals fat loss, which actually isn't the case. Now, one of the reasons why weight loss is not linear and it doesn't progress in a linear fashion is that you don't just lose fat when you're losing weight, you will also lose muscle and you'll lose water, and there's so many things that influence that number on the scale. It's not just fat. But I am assuming, for the purposes of this video, to keep it simple, that when we're talking about weight loss, we're assuming it's just fat loss. So in order to lose weight, you need to be in a calorie deficit. That will allow your body to use its fat stores for fuel, because it doesn't, you're not giving it enough fuel in the form of food. So there's this kind of rule that goes something like this, right? In order to lose a pound of fat, you need to be in a 3,500 calorie deficit. And the reason for that is a pound of fat stores 3,500 calories worth of energy. You wouldn't normally create a 3,500 calorie deficit for the day. That will most likely mean you're eating no food at all and having to exercise too much. What you'd normally do is you'd spread that deficit out over the course of the week. So in order to lose a pound of fat per week, what you need to do is create a 3,500 calorie deficit for the whole week. So what that looks like is you have each day of the week, and then you'll divide that by 7 to get 500 calories per day as your deficit. So say you normally eat 2,500 calories, what you'd do is you'd create a deficit by then eating 2,000 calories per day. And if you did that, you could expect to lose a pound of weight per week. Now, going back to what I said before, you might lose a little bit less, because if you gain some water as a result from the stress of your diet, or you might lose a little bit more if you cut out a whole heap of carbs and then you lose a whole heap of water. So it's not going to be precisely a pound, but that is what could be expected if weight loss equaled fat loss. So this is the hypothetical situation, and that does happen, but what you will find eventually is that this 500 calorie deficit stops working. Like, you start to lose maybe only half a pound, or eventually you'll get to a point where you don't lose any weight and the scale is not moving. Now, there are a number of reasons why this could be the case. One of the most common ones, honestly, is that you stop being consistent. It is very, very hard to stay consistent to a 500 calorie deficit per day. It's actually quite a big deficit, depending on what your maintenance calorie is and what you're used to eating and a number of things, but you're going to be hungry, and to sustain that for a long period of time, it's very likely you are going to get kind of diet fatigue. So you get sick of your diet and you notice things are working, so you start to allow a little bit more flexibility into your diet, and before you know it, one day of having like a treat meal becomes 2 days and then 3 days, and before you know it, you're not actually in that deficit that you were when you started your diet, and that is why progress has stalled. Now, let's say you are 100% consistent with your diet, it's still going to stall and stop working. It makes sense, kind of, right? Like, if you weigh 150 pounds and you kept up this consistently for a year, that means you would lose 50 pounds over the course of the year, and you would be very, very, very small. That's a massive drop in weight. So it makes sense that the body is going to try and slow things down and stop this from happening, which is actually the case. What happens at the start of your diet, just say your total daily energy expenditure is 2,500 calories. So your total daily energy expenditure is just all the energy that it costs to run your body and to maintain your body weight as it is right now. So if you eat the same amount of food as your total daily energy expenditure, you will maintain your weight. Now, if you set up a diet and create a calorie deficit, that means you're eating in a deficit from your total daily energy expenditure. That is when weight loss will happen. So say your diet calories come down to 2000 calories. What is actually going to happen by the end of your diet, and the timing is different for everyone based on a number of factors I'm going to go into, the end of your diet, your total daily energy expenditure actually adapts to your diet calories. So your end total daily energy expenditure becomes 2000 calories as well. And because you're currently eating 2000 calories, you're matching your energy expenditure and you will stop losing weight. So in other words, your maintenance calories change as you lose weight. Your maintenance calories are dynamic. They're always changing based on so many things. And it's a big mistake to think that as long as you keep eating 2000 calories, you'll keep making progress, because it's not the case at all. Your diet calories are not going to work forever. That is where you might need to implement measures to help you overcome the plateau and keep weight loss progressing. Now, the main reasons that your total daily energy expenditure adapts have to do with your basal metabolic rate, your NEAT, and to an extent, the thermic effect of food decreasing. So when you go on a diet and you start losing weight, all of these components of your total daily energy expenditure start to decrease. And because your BMR is decreasing, because your NEAT, your non-exercise activity, decreases, and because to an extent this, but not really, that's your thermic effect of food. So if you're eating less food, you're going to require less energy to digest and absorb it. And if you're on a diet, you're probably eating less food than what you were when you weren't on the diet. But this is such a small component of your total daily energy expenditure. It doesn't really have that much of an effect, but it does decrease. And your exercise activity, that depends on what you're doing. You might keep it the same, you might decrease it. Naturally, it kind of will decrease because you're not going to have the energy that you did at the start of your diet to put into your workouts. But we're just going to say it doesn't really matter anyway, because again, it's a very small component of your total daily energy expenditure. Like, it makes up a small proportion of it. The components that make up the biggest proportion of your total daily energy expenditure are your BMR, or basal metabolic rate, or your metabolism, and your non-exercise activity. And when you diet, when you're eating in a calorie deficit, you gradually lose weight, and the biggest contributing factor of your metabolic rate is your mass. So if you are losing weight, your total daily energy expenditure is going to decrease because your BMR decreases. And when you go on a diet, your non-exercise activity is naturally going to decrease as well, because your body is going to make you feel less like moving, I guess. Like, you naturally start to fidget less, you don't feel like standing up as much, you don't feel like walking and moving around as much, just as part of having less energy. And so your NEAT decreases, your mass decreases, and that is the main reason why your diet calories eventually will stop working, because your total daily energy expenditure will decrease. So in order to overcome this, what you are going to need to do is you're going to need to either increase your NEAT levels. Often you can do this by adding cardio to your routine or increasing your steps. Say you started with a step target at the start of your diet of like 8,000 steps a day. If you increase your step target to 12,000 steps or something like that, that will help increase your energy expenditure to help you kickstart weight loss again. Now, you can't really stop your mass from decreasing, because obviously that is the goal of weight loss or fat loss. But what you can do then is change your diet calories. Once your diet calories match your total daily energy expenditure, another way to keep weight loss progressing is to reduce your calorie intake further. So what that means is your diet calories will then become maybe 1800 calories instead. So you don't necessarily have to take another 500 calories off, because that will probably result in you not being able to eat much at all, especially if you're female and your calories are already quite low. So what I would usually recommend is just taking off an extra 100 calories or maybe 200 calories in some cases, and that should be enough to kickstart a weight loss process again and keep things moving forward. I have a whole article on plateaus on my website that will explain in more detail some of your options that you can apply if you have hit a plateau, and also how to know that you've actually hit a plateau, because you don't want to implement these strategies if you haven't even hit a plateau yet. Like, save them until you really hit a plateau, because you will plateau and then you need something in your back pocket to pull out so that you can actually overcome it. I'll put a link to that article in the description box. If you have any questions on this and your situation, please send me an email. I'll also put that in the description box. This is simplified, but I hope it does help you understand a little bit better why you plateau and why weight loss doesn't keep progressing the way you want it to. That is all for this video. If you liked it, please hit the like button and subscribe. If that is the case, I will see you in the next video.